So now coming to the next phase of recommendations, which is the technique. What are different techniques of recommendations? So these are only the most well-known techniques of recommendation system that we are going to discuss. There are some other techniques that is not in the scope of this lecture. We will discuss in some other parts also. So the first most important technique is the content-based filtering technique. So what a content-based filtering technique? Content-based suggests items similar to the ones that user preferred in the past. So whatever the item you have preferred in the past, the similar items will be suggested to you. Let's suppose you always preferred the Nokia phones, so only Nokia phones will be suggested to you. No other phones will be suggested to you, right? So if you have preferred the books, then the same type of books will be recommended to the you in future, right? For example, let's take an example for better understanding. If you go to YouTube and on YouTube you search motivational video, okay, so you just search a single motivational video, you watch it, and whenever you go to your YouTube timeline, you'll see there are a lot of recommendations of the similar motivational videos. Why? Because the search engine, the recommendation engine which is working behind this YouTube, have identified that you like most the motivational videos. So motivational videos will be recommended to you, right? Now coming to the second technique, which is the collaborative filtering. Collaborative filtering technique is the most widely implemented technique in the field of recommendations. So what collaborative filtering does is suggest items on the basis of user's neighbors. So whatever my neighbor is doing or whatever my friend is doing, all these things will be suggested to me. For example, if I add X as in my friend list, then this X will also be recommended to my friend Y, right? So I and my friend Y both were friend. If I add X into my friend list, then this X also be recommended to a Y. So this is how the Facebook is working on the basis of collaborative filtering. So it is a group of friends where a group of friends recommended particular item to the user, right? We'll see later in the later slide more about the collaborative filtering. Now coming to the next, which is the demographic filtering. Demographic filtering is nothing but a collaborative filtering which uses the demographic information of the users. So what are those demographic information? The demographic information can be the city of the user, the age of the user, the occupation of the user, or the gender of the user. So based on those demographic information, if recommendations are made, then this is known as the demographic filtering. For example, if I say that this product is only meant for the female candidates, then the recommendations are based on this female category. So this is the demographic information, right? So on the basis of this demographic information, we are generating the recommendations to a group of people. So this is the demographic filtering. Now the last one is the hybrid filtering. So hybrid filtering is nothing but a combination of multiple recommendation techniques. Like you can combine the content with the collaborative or collaborative with the content. So this is how you can combine the multiple collaborative filtering, multiple recommendation techniques in order to build a hybrid filtering technique. Now we will discuss more about this recommendation techniques in detail. So what happening in the content based recommendations? So here you can see in the user preference profile is the key. So what is the user preference profile? User preference profile is a set of information about a user. For example, 75% time a user preferred a motivational video. So a profile of a user will be made that 75% this user preferred the motivational video, And the 25% this user likes the comedy videos. So this is the profile of a single user. So whatever the recommendation will be made, the 75% content will be from motivational section. And the 25% recommendation will be made from the comedy section. So this is the profile of the user. And how this profile is going to made? Based on the past experiences, the recommendation system identify what is the preference of the user in the past, and based on that, the profile of the each user is created, right? Matching user preferences with item characteristics. So as I said earlier, that it will identify, okay, 75% he likes the motivational video, and this video is also from motivational section, so he will definitely like this one. Okay, so this is how the matching is going to perform. Now the third point, design mostly to recommend text-based items. What is text? The content in the system is usually described with the keywords. So if I say text-based items, so what it is only applicable for those items which have some keywords, some text, right? Some content. So if there is a movie, the movie should be from the motivational movie, the comedy movie, the action thriller movie, the sci-fi. So all these are the keywords or the text of the item. So if there is no text associated with it, the content-based filtering will not work. So content-based technique works mainly on the content-based items. So there are some limitations of the content-based method. So what are those limitations? The first one is limited content analysis. So this method is based on text, but not all content is well represented by the keywords. So you might have seen that some users uploaded the videos without any description about it. So if I upload this video lecture on YouTube without giving some information and just I write XYZ, then nobody is going to search this particular video based on this content. So if the content is not associated with particular item, then this technique going to fail. The second one is over specialization. So what is over specialization? Let's suppose you are going to write your exam, right? Then what happened? You want some motivation, and in order to gain some motivation, you watch some motivational videos on the YouTube, right? You watch the videos, what you YouTube thinks you want more motivation. It will brought more motivational video on your timeline. You will see more motivational videos, right? After the examinations, what you want? You don't want motivation, right? You want entertainment. You want some comedy kind of steps, some action kind of movies. But what is happening in the on your timeline? It is still showing the motivational videos. So this kind of problem is known as the over-specialization. It means the preference of a user changes over the time, and the recommender system can't identify that at this particular time the preference of this particular user is going to change, right? New user problem. Now this is a very interesting problem in the content-based filtering method. New user problem means, let's suppose a new user comes into the picture or in the system, right? So how you are going to recommend a particular item to this particular user? Because you don't have the profile of the user, you don't have the history of this user, you don't have the what are the past preferences of this particular user. So system can't identify what are the preferences of this particular user in the past, so I can't say that this user will like this particular item. So this is the limitation of content-based filtering